We are going to record this session, and we can later share the recording with you, so that so that you can, maybe if you had missed certain parts, then you can refer to them. Also, as a reminder to all of you, that yesterday we recorded like over 5 hours of learning, so it's now up on YouTube. We sent you guys the link this afternoon, so you can go and watch. We already showed you how you can download files from YouTube. Yeah, let me share my screen and show you. Well, last time we showed you how to download videos from YouTube. So this is our channel, and please go and subscribe, because now we have content piling up. You can see all of these videos, we just uploaded them off late. So yeah, so the latest one is this one, Excel, 5 hours, like 5 hours and 11 minutes. Then we have the other one. This is 2 hours, 42 minutes. That was the other Sunday. Then the other one is 4 hours, 12 minutes. So you have a whole bunch of materials now to watch. But also, if you are not comfortable viewing on YouTube, we can still put it on what we call WeTransfer. And by the way, I forgot to include WeTransfer here. It is one way of also sharing files without, like, files of up to 2 GB. If you don't want to upload it to your Google Drive, you can also do it on WeTransfer. Then you can get a link, and then somebody will download it. You can upload up to 2 GB of data on it. So this is the one for you to watch. Let me just put the link here in the chat. Yes, so, but we also had those in all of the emails that were sent you since yesterday. Maybe before we get started, does anyone have a question? And I see someone's hand is up. Please unmute and talk. Guest, who is guest? Please unmute and talk.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I'm so glad we have come to the end of this training. I'm so excited. Thankful, I've learned a lot. Thank you, Joel, and the other trainers. I'm kindly requesting if we could, I failed to get the tutorials you people had talked about. I don't know whether the problem is my network, my email, but I failed to get them. I've not yet gotten them. Thank you very much.
To answer your question, this is our YouTube channel. We've uploaded everything here. This was for yesterday, as you can see. And then there are also some other smaller tutorials here. And this is from the other day. So let me just put the link again on the chat. But also expect the same the emails we're going to send you this evening. And you can download files from YouTube. I hope you now know how to do it, because that's something we learned last week. Yeah, if you have any questions on how to use it, please let us know. Otherwise, someone in the house can also just quickly tell us.
Yeah, I can go. I'm listening for
Aiden. Vivian, yes. You guys, your microphones are on. Do you want to say something? And please, if you'd like to say something, kindly raise your hand up, and then we'll pick on you. Otherwise, these are the files. Check on your chat. You're going to see a link. You will download anything from here. But also, let me now begin the session straight away by showing you how to... I'm going to do what we call WeTransfer. I'm going to upload something on WeTransfer. It's also another way of transferring files, apart from maybe Google Drive. Or what do you guys think? Do you want us to put it on the Google Drive? Yeah, so let me download this from yesterday. Okay, we're going to handle the file issue. maybe let's go straight to Google Forms and how you can do a very good Google questions. Like, it's really good for research, and also in the professional context, you can use those. Let's say you are like an HR working for a big company, but you want people to submit something. Maybe you want them to submit their telephone numbers, their account numbers, their NSSF numbers, but then you don't want to write to everyone and then they write to you in an email. Like, you're going to receive a whole bunch of emails and that will be very inconveniencing. There's a way you could just develop an online form, then they fill it out and it all comes to you, like, very easy, and you'll know who has filled it out and who hasn't. So we use Google Forms. Also, the application you filled out when you were applying to this program, it was done on Google Forms. So let's go straight. I'm going to show you, first of all, what we did, the exact application you guys filled out, so that you can have an idea of what we're going to do. So we are not going to be doing a lengthy thing. We're just showing you how you can do the things. So it's here. Yeah, so most of you have filled out this kind of forms and you're wondering how the people do it, and you think this needs a lot of IT skills. But I can tell you now, this is something anyone should be able to do. And it would save you lots of paper work. It could also save you lots of time and also money. You know, this is what we did. And I believe guys who applied, you were able to see this kind of thing. Let me go to preview and you'll be able to see it clearly. One second. So this was the application. Like, you can manage it very well. Now I can see 113 people responded. So these are the applications that we received. Yes. And then we were able to select a few. Yeah. So you can have a logo somewhere, then you can have a heading, then you can have a welcome thing. You can do something like this. Then you can now have sections. You can have questions. So we're going to show you how you can do all of these questions. There are different kinds of questions. They are like short answer questions. They are like multiple choice questions. They are also the drag and drops. Also, some questions will ask you to select a date. And then we'll also show you how you can put the date just by using the drop down, you know. And if somebody saw this, they'll be like, wow, this is very well done. So you're going to do one by yourself just now, and it won't take 30 minutes, trust me. Someone, Vivian, please just kindly mute, because your microphone is popping up often, and we're also sharing our screen. We may not have to be going back to that meeting window back and forth. So straight away, this is it, but I want to change it to our official account. So first of all, you need to log into Gmail. Once you logged into Gmail, one second. Yeah, this is Gmail. I'm logged into Gmail. And now what I want to do is, I want to go to the Ludo thing, the nine dots, click on it. Then you scroll all the way to Google Forms, this one down, and you click on it. I'm going to launch my campaign because I think it helps. Oh, sorry. So it's opening. Let's wait for it. So now, right now, as you can see, we are now in Google Forms. You can create a blank one. Like, there are also templates which you can just choose and then edit. Let's see what is there in the templates. Personal, if it is find a time, probably this is like something like a slot. This is a reservation. Probably you want to send people a form to like confirm if they are coming to your birthday or something. Party invite, like something like that. T-shirt sign up, event registration. Feedback, you can also make a feedback form. Okay, we're going to do feedback because after this, we'll actually ask you guys to give us feedback on what you've learned until now. So, but you can also create your own, like start from scratch. Like, it's very easy. So there is someone's hand up. Let me see who that is. If you're there, kindly unmute. So yeah, I want to use this template or feedback. I'll click on it. And please, if you have any questions, just feel free to stop me at any point, and then we'll fix your issue right away. So now this is a feedback form. I'm going to change this photo. I'm also going to change all of this. Please make sure you edit it well. Just unmute and talk, please. The one who is raising the hand, who's that?
I'm not seeing the screen.
Can you see my screen, Gertrude? You cannot. Oops. I think you're taking. The screen is coming right to you. I hope you can see it now. And thanks for reminding me. If you can't see my screen for some reason, just let me know, because we are dealing with technology and it can't be 100% perfect. It's a cool thing, but we cannot guarantee 100% satisfaction. So just keep reminding me. Can you see the screen now, Barbara?
Yes, thank you.
I don't know at which point we lost the screen. Otherwise, did you guys all see how I got here?
No, I stopped at the forms, the different forms.
The forms here. The templates here. Okay. I'm going to close it and just begin it all over. So once you're logged in, you go to these little dots, you scroll all the way to forms. You click on it, and you wait, and it will load for you something like this. And So you are free to choose a template which is already here, for as long as it matches with what you've done. If you want to expand these templates, right now I see 1, 2, 3. If I want to see all of them, I just click on here. Then I will be able to see all of them. Call them. Sorry. Some people are still trying to call us because I think they didn't receive the link or something. We're not sure. But yeah, you will see all of these templates and you choose the one you want to use. If you also want to do your blank one, you can also just create it all from scratch. Which one do you guys want us to do? Do you want us to do one from scratch, or we just edit what is already there? I wanted us to edit what is already there, because especially this one, the feedback, because we're going to let you guys give us feedback on the training. What do you think? Well, let's go with that. I'll click on. Go ahead.
Can we do like the feedback and a blank one, please?
Okay, that's fine. So let's do it quick. We are not doing everything. So feedback, you click on it. This one. So now you need to edit it properly. You need to change this image. I'm going to start by changing the image. To change the image, actually it took me 2 years to learn how to change the image. I only learned it when I was doing the Kectil application lately. So you come here to customize theme. There's this kind of apple with the dots. I don't know if it's an apple. Yeah, so you click on the apple. You don't eat it, of course. Then you go there to image uploaded. Yeah, you go there and you click on the image thing, then you wait, you go to upload, then you wait, then you browse. Now from here you can drag and drop, just as they say, or you can even browse. Two ways. I like the easier way of doing it because I'm lazy. So we have our logo here. Let me see, Kectil logo, yeah. So this is our logo. I want to just carry it from here and release it there. So now it's being uploaded. Let's see. So from here, because it can't fit all of the image, so you need to crop. What should people see? I would like it, maybe if they see part of our thing here, like Kectil. Yeah, I want to leave it like that. I'm now happy with that. Then I'll just say done. And then this image is going to go, and our logo is going to come. Exactly what you guys saw in the application. Now I'll close this window, and then I'll come here to tell us what your experience has been with ICT. So this is like the heading, you know. Okay, like you can customize it to. Okay, I want to say, please help us improve ICT training, something like this. So I'm happy with that. Then you can make a short description here. I can say, thank you for participating in our training, in our ICT training that kicked off on November 6th and ended today, November 14th. We hope you had as much fun attending and we did organizing. Okay. I'll not change much because this is like a feedback form, so it is similar to what I want to do. So that's why sometimes the template is going to save you time. But if you were to build it from scratch, then like you need to fill all of this by yourself. But somebody already wrote something similar to what we want to do, but just don't take it the way they've written it, because that would be plagiarism. You know, you have to write your own. We want to hear your feedback so we can keep improving our logistics and content. Please fill this quick survey and let us know your thoughts. Your answers will be anonymous. By anonymous, we mean we are not going to disclose your your answers to anyone. So feel free to say anything. So that is it. And now, how satisfied were you with the event, with the training? Okay, I'll say training instead of event. Now, here you can choose linear scale. You can also, do you want us to leave it like this? Because now the linear scale is going to be a ranking. One means not very. And if you choose five, it means very much, like very much satisfied. We can even change it to multiple choice. Okay, let's do a drop down. Okay, now option number one, I want to say dissatisfied. Then I want to say satisfied. Then I want to say neutral. Then number three, I want to say not really. And I want to say very satisfied. And I want to say very this. I don't know if that's the right spelling for dissatisfied. So I'll leave it like that. This one is not yet added, but if you want to add again, you just click there and you'll write. So now here we are. These are, and then if you want to make it a required question, you like the one with the star. So that means somebody has to answer it before they can go to the next question. You can also make it optional by just turning it off. I want it to be required because I really want to know how people felt during the 4 weekend days. Yes?
There's a question.
Yes?
Someone saying, let's talk about uploading questionnaires on say, what they get, what they collect, and so on.
Someone is asking a totally different kind of application. I really like the enthusiasm, but today we won't really have time to like do those data collection and analysis programs. Maybe we can do those on like a case by case basis, because now if we are to do ODK right now or Kobo Collect or SPSS, it's going to be like that needs like a whole day, you know. It's like a whole day. But also Google Forms can help you also analyze data, because you can collect information and it can also analyze for you just simply like in like graphical forms or in pie charts automatically. Like you just don't have to do anything. So that person can actually write to us an email so we can see how to help them. Yes. We actually have people who are interested in learning SPSS, so we'll see how to arrange with them. So now I'm done with this question. I'll scroll down. I'll scroll down to this. How relevant and helpful do you think this training was for you? Was for you. I'm not gonna say your job, but because I know not everyone is working, others are let's say for you. But then again, now I can leave this linear scale and it's required. Let's go to the next one. What were your key takeaways from this event? Now, the reason this person has put a short answer question is because now this is something asking your personal experience. Like we can't really have true or false. So you have to tell us from your mind. So we will give you some space where you will type answers. So that's why from here, they chose short answer. There's a whole bunch. You know, you can even say they have to upload something. You know, you can say, I want this one to be a file upload. In fact, let's see one where we're going to say upload your profile photo or something like that. Yeah. So so we'll say short answer for now. Key takeaways for you. Takeaways, I think it should be one word. Takeaways. Yeah. So we'll go to the next. How satisfied were you with the logistics? Okay, accommodation is not there. So we'll just remove it from here by clicking on this kind of this cross, you know. You can remove it, whatever you feel. Welcome kit, I think we had a welcome kit, like we sent you the trainer profile, the training schedule, and a whole bunch of things. Communication, we also sent you emails. Transportation, we didn't provide one, so we'll remove that. Welcome activity, yes, because we had some onboarding webinar, like a trial webinar sort of, we did one. Venue, yes, for those who came, but also for those that are attending online, so both the online and offline. So I'll just say in brackets, both offline and online. And then activities during the training, like the kind of interaction that we have, our methodology, maybe, I don't know, closing ceremony, we don't have one. Maybe we should think of having something like that. I'll remove this, not applicable. Yes, so now, as you can see, but you can always add like another row. So these five matches with that, these four matches with that. So now we are good. But if you want to add like a sixth row, maybe trainers, and I want to add number six. So you see, yeah. So, and I want it to be required, you know. How satisfied were you? So it's going to be multiple choice with grid. So now you're going to choose. This is the rows that talk about like the particular activities, and then these are like the scores. This is how you rank. So I think, yeah, it's going to be displayed like this. I will show you how to do that. Then the other thing I want to show you also is you can copy and paste this question, this exact one. If you wanted to come down, you can just say duplicate. You can also delete like the entire question. You know, there are also some other options here. But additional feedback on logistics. Now this one also, like I said, this requires you to write something. So we'll leave it like fill in some blank, sort of some essay. But you can also put like, I don't know, we can also put word counts to like how many words should fit here. I don't know if I can do that now. Word counts, description, short description. No. I'm going to figure that out. Yeah, but okay, then this one, which session did you find most relevant? Welcome activity. Then maybe I want to say day one, intro to what, and PPT stands for PowerPoint, Excel, Canva. What did we learn yesterday? It was Excel, right? What else did we learn? PowerPoint. We also learned email, Google. Sorry. Hope you guys are still able to see my screen. There we are now. Forms, Zoom. So you can add them the way you want. And I want to add this one. I want to add the sixth one. Yes, we're good. How satisfied with you with the session content? All of them, all of the training modules from day one to the last. So make sure that you edit whatever information this person I put, and you're free to change any additional comments, any overall feedback, name, you can put your name and it's optional. So that means we're not going to receive names from people. So now let's preview this and see. But if you want to preview, come to this kind of this eye icon. Let's see how it looks. So now this is our logo. Please help us improve the ICT training. Then we have a description there. You know, there is an email, but it's not going to be shown to you guys. Then these are the required ones with the stars. You cannot go ahead if you don't fill them up. So basically that is it, like it's awesome. And then you click on submit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this link and then I will send it to you guys on the chat. Then I want you to just quickly just type something. Maybe I'm not going to make it required. How satisfied were you? This is the other thing that we made, the drop down. So you click on it and then you choose the one you. The other thing I want to show you now, if you want to go back to editing, click on this pen. We're back to editing. I want to have another question somewhere that will require us to put a date. Maybe I want to have it here. I'm going to duplicate this. I'll just say duplicate. So now we have two questions here. The first one is there. Now I want my question to be, On which day did you join the training? So now I want it to be a date, not drop down. I change it from here. Let me see, date is here. So, and I'll put it required, you know. So now let's go and preview and see. I mean, there's a whole bunch of things you guys can play around with. We're not going to take so much time. So you see, now the date is here. The calendar is here. What you can do is you can fill it out like this by just saying month is 11, day is 06. It has to be two digits, just as you can see, 2021. That's okay. But also, if you just want to click on this calendar icon and then you just choose for yourself. I like to do that because that's easier. That is if I'm on the computer. But if I'm on the phone, then yeah, if you're on the phone, I think just click on the calendar and then choose. Now, the next thing, which is now the most important, is let's go back to editing, is sending your form for people to now fill out. So, but there are still some settings that we need to do. If we come to here, settings, make this a quiz. Manage responses. Okay, click on this. Now, collect email addresses. Do you want to collect people's emails? This means that whoever fills out this form, their email will come to you. But you don't want, because somewhere I remember you said it's going to be anonymous. So if it's anonymous, then you don't want to collect people's contact information. Even that's why we have put the name to be optional. So we're not going to collect email addresses. So be careful with this. If it's an application form like you guys filled out, actually, we didn't also want to collect your email addresses. That's why when we selected you, we called all of you on phone. Then we said, can you give us your email address? Because we care about confidentiality. You know, send responders a copy of their response. So this means if you turn it on, whatever answers they will put is going to be sent back to them also, to their emails. But this only works when you have turned on the first option of collecting emails. But if you're not collecting emails, anyone can fill in this form without even logging in. But if you want to collect emails, then they are not going to do it unless they are logged in. That's why it says collect emails. Allow response editing. After somebody has submitted, do you want them to still edit? They can still. Require sign in? No. So, but if you want to turn it on, then they have to be signed into Gmail in order to access. But you don't want to do this because not everyone uses Gmail, right? Some people use Yahoo, some people use other accounts. How responses are managed? So let's go here. Show the progress bar. The progress bar is something like this. Let me show you here in our Kectil application. I don't know if you have it. Oh, we already closed applications. But let me open it again. I'll open it. By the way, you can close applications, you can also open. Like we said, it was ending, I think it was 11:59. So 11:59, we closed it. So if somebody tried to say, oh no, they are no longer accepting applications. You can also edit this message. So you can say, sorry, you're late. You are late. Try again next time. Send us an email, because now you don't want them to just be locked out. You want to give them an option so they can at least send us an email. Send us an email at kectil.uganda@gmail.com. I mean, it's up to you. You can customize it. Now, what I wanted to show you was the progress bar. So I'll turn this on. Let's see if we have it here. I don't know if we don't have it, but for once you turn it on, let me turn it on here in our, sorry, you come to settings, manage our presentations, show progress bar, this one. So I've turned it on. Let's preview and see. So this is what we are talking about. So someone can say, oh, I've already filled 2%, 10%. So if your form is very long, you don't want to show this because people will get this kind of, oh my, it's too long, you know. If you know it's a long one, please don't put it. If it's a short one, well and good. And this one is showing page 1 of 2. So that means we only have 2 pages. So if somebody has come, please say, oh, I've already finished 1 page, so let me just go and finish the other page, then I can go and sleep. But if there are 10 pages, it's also going to show up here, and it will discourage someone from completing the application. I hope you understand that. That's the progress bar. So we can turn it on because ours is very short. And then, yeah, these are just the basics, but we are not going to go to the very advanced. there are some advanced features that you can also have. Let's say if somebody has answered A, question A, they should automatically jump question B and they go to question C. So you can also set it up. But for now, I think this can get you started and we can help you through the process. And now let's go to send. And then you don't want to send it by email, you just want to get a link. Like we've shown you how to use links last time, like yesterday. And now Google is good because it has what we call the Google URL shortener. You can shorten it without taking it to the other Bitly. But also if you like Bitly, you can just leave it like this. You copy this link, then you go to Bitly, you know. It's still going to be the same. You can shorten it here. Shorten it here. This is the link. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to put it somewhere here. I'll say Bitly because I want you to like confirm, you know. Bitly, then it's like this. And let's get the Google one because I want us to confirm. Where is the Google one? Is this one? Let me shorten it and then I copy and I take it to Word. Here, Google. These are like the same links. Google doesn't do it so well. You see, this is still long, but Bitly does it really. It's very short. So, which one do you prefer? It's up to you. So, after you've shortened this link, you just copy this. This is what you need to send somebody now to their email. You will now say, "This is the link. Please apply." So, if you try the link there, let's see. If it will bring someone here to bring them. But now, assuming somebody has not logged into to their email, let's also try. Before you send it out, please try because I remember we attended a training lately in Nairobi and then somebody sent us photos in a Google Drive, but they didn't give us the access, you know, like to edit something which we showed you guys yesterday. And we couldn't, and we have not accessed it until now, and she was annoyed, and she could not edit it. So you need to try everything, like just take your time and let's see, I'm going to sign out. Okay. Time is going really, really, really fast. I think we are not logged in. Let me try if I'll be able to access it here. If it works, yeah, it works without signing, you know. But if you want to save your progress, you can sign in. So this is the form, you fill it up, and then the progress bar is here. It is only one page. I'm happy with this because I'll only take 5 minutes to complete it. So let me send it to you guys on our meeting, then you can try. So try if that works either on phone and also before you send it out to people, try on phone and try on the computer and you see if it works on both devices. Yes, otherwise that's how we can do a Google form using templates. The other way is starting from scratch. So you go there, go to forms. It's still the same, but let's just see the interface and how it looks. So you go to blank. This is like when you open Microsoft Office Word, they are like templates, right? Where you can say, hey, there's a calendar here, so you can quickly jump to what you want, but you can also create your own. So this is like the blank one. Your feedback on the ICT training. Please help us improve this for future participants by filling out the short form below. So now that is it. Then you just start doing questions. You're going to do question number one here. What is your name? But I'm going to make it optional. I'm not going to make it required because I want to keep anonymity. Now, without the template, you come here to plus to add a question, right? come to the plus, and then a question will be added. Then you type it. Which date did you join the training? But also be polite, you know, use words like please, also, you know, kindly, do you mind, you know, like you want people to be motivated. You can't just say, what is your name? When did you come here? Why did you take the training? You know, like you try to phrase your things. Again, that's like a different feel. That's communication. We are also going to learn communication here, you know, because many people actually after training, and I know this is the same, and now this is the cool thing. When you type date here, Google automatically detects, oh, he wants to put a date. Then here, it will just come to date, unless you want to change. So automatically, it just came. I did not choose it. That is how it happens. Now, the other thing is you can actually add sections. You can go to, wait, no, here, add a section. You can have sections to your questionnaire. You can say, this section is like maybe biography, maybe background. Then the other section is content. So there is a break here, you see, there's a bar. So this would be an equivalent of a page, you know. There is on this page, I'm only asking about name, telephone number, WhatsApp number, what Skype. And now on the second page, now I want to talk about logistics. Even I can title it logistics. Then I said here we would like to understand your level of satisfaction with our logistical arrangements. And then you start now adding questions using the plus. So this is question number one under logistics section. You understand? So how did you attend the training? Maybe I want to say physical. And the other option is online. So what was your level of satisfaction? What was your level . So now on the level, maybe I want to change the responses to be something like a linear scale, something like this. One means low, and then five means high, maybe. Very. Poor, okay, let's say poor and excellent. So if somebody chooses five, it means it's excellent. If they choose two, it is something in between. Three, something in the middle, you know. So then I have another section. Now on this section, I'll say additional information. I'll say these are optional, but we would appreciate if you could spend a minute and just fill out the few. I know some of you can type like one word per minute. Like, it's also something we are going to learn, like we should have started with this. Because also when people are hiring you, there is, these days you actually see the test. We call them touch typing tests. So now this is question number one under additional information. I won't say anything else. Then I want it to be like a sort of a short answer, because anything else, it should come from your mind, you know? So that is how we can do it, guys. And then the other options will all be the same. So this is it. I also forgot to put a logo. Maybe I'll also put the progress bar here so someone can see where they've reached. Let me add a logo. You come here to the Apple, and after you pressed on the Apple, you don't eat the Apple, of course. Wait, let me refresh it. I don't know why. Is it my internet? Look, internet's fine. Apple. But you can try it. It's definitely going to work, you know. Yeah, here. So I want to say I want to upload. I want to just drag and drop because I like dragging things and dropping things. Because that's like the easier way of doing it. So unfortunately, we have to stop because we have a whole bunch of other things you guys have to learn. But this is also being recorded. You're going to watch it and you can also do your practice. It's being recorded. So, and then you just play with the settings. Sorry. Oh, there's a question in the chat. Let me just see. Kindly take us through on how to apply skips when drafting a Google form. I think we should do this. What do you think? Okay, so let's say, let me add a question. Let's say maybe if somebody has answered some question, they should now skip a question. Let's say now, okay, in this case, we have people who are attending online and then people who are attending offline. There are certain questions that are only going to apply to the online people. So again, let's come here. Let's say on this section, there's a section. Let me add a section here. Add a section. This section is for online, you know, online attendees. Please complete this only if you attended sessions remotely. So now I have a question. I go to plus question. On which platform were the meetings held? Maybe I'll say Zoom. I'll say big blue button, and I'll say TeamViewer. So it's like a multiple choice. I will choose. Now, I have another section here for offline attendees. Then I want to describe it, please. Only those that attended training. From the office should complete this section. Okay. I want to correct that. And before you even send your things out, how neat was the office training facility? You see, automatically Google will say linear scale because they've detected it is a how question. So the how questions are like testing your level of satisfaction. So automatically, you know, they have a technology that will detect. So one will say we'll say dirty. So maybe one will be like dirty, then clean. You know, so if somebody did one, it means dirty. Two, somehow. Three, you know. Okay. Now, let's say there is a beginning question here, just right here. I'm going to add a question. I will say, what was your mode of attendance? So now here I want it to be a drop down. And one is going to be online, and the other is physical. Now, if you choose physical, I want them to now go straight to they will not do this. You know? Yeah. So there is some sort of a connection programming we have to do. Evelyn, your microphone is disturbing. Is that the right word to use? I simply meant your microphone was making noise. Okay, I want this one to, and by the way, there is a way you can drag questions. I want this one to be like the last question here. No. Okay. I want this question to go down after, should be just the last one here. After you've completed that, then where is it? Okay, it has to go just right up. So if you want to drag it, if you move your cursor around, it's going to bring these four arrows. Once you see the four arrows, just click and move wherever you want it to go. So I want this one to be here, and then the next is another section. So I want them, after they've completed this section, I want them to jump straight to this one, either online or offline. So let's see. I don't remember if I can still do that, but I'm going to do it, don't worry. So after this one, this is the option. Go to section based on your answer. Okay, we're going to make this option to be after here. So from the beginning up to logistics, it's still for everyone. So you can fill it in order, no problem. But now after logistics, we have now online and we have offline. So if you answer offline, then you need to go to the section for offline. So here, I'll just click on this question. Then there is this dot. No. Okay. I got it just now, I think here. Yes. Recordings of yesterday, guys. It is here on our YouTube channel. It is here. We've sent the emails again and again. I'm going to put the link just now. And every email that we're going to send, we're going to list all of those recordings. So it's not difficult for us. It's just copying and pasting. So let's go back here. There's something I am trying, but it's not. Okay, I think from here, from this section, continue to next section. Go to, no. Where was the question? I think here, I click on the dot. Sorry guys, something is not working. Anyways, there is a function I am looking for, but okay, first of all, I want to move this question up, this one, because now I want the other last question in this section to, what did I do? Logistics, okay. I want this one to be the last question under logistics section. Now, let's see. So now, after you've answered physical or online, there is just these three little dots. Go to section based on answer. So you click on that. So now, physical, if somebody answered physical, they should now go to physical section. Offline here. You understand? So you choose offline. If somebody has answered online, then you come here to the drop down, they should go to online attendees. So let's try and see if this is going to work. I'm going to answer online and I will see if I'll still be able to see this one. Okay, I'm going to answer offline and I will see if it will skip this one. Okay, so let's preview and see. Thank you for asking that question. That's really cool, you know, because if I've answered offline, why do I have to see things about online people? Like, it doesn't concern me, right? So it would be annoying if I saw those. So now Let me fill this. These are actually not mandatory. You can even skip them. You know, whenever you don't see a star, it means it's not mandatory. It's optional. So they are at your mercy. If you want to give them something, you can give them. If you don't want to give them something, you can just continue. I'll just go next because I don't have the time. Even here, okay, now here, I'm going to do offline, yeah? Then let me see. It has to take me to offline section. Offline, that's it. That's all. So, but let me go back and see and change my answer. Online, let me go next and see. Online attendees. I think that's brilliant. So I want to congratulate this guy and thank him again for, who was that? Brian. So Brian, you've really opened up our eyes. So does anyone have a question how to use Google Forms? I believe at this point, you can build a Google Form and your boss will be like, wow, how did you do this? And set all of these functions, put your company logo and everything, and they'll be amazed. Otherwise, we're going to move to the next thing. Any questions? Okay, there is nothing in the chat. No one is raising a hand. At this point, I can say we are now very good with Google Forms. And again, we have built this one for Kectil. If we want to receive applications again, we are just going to open it. Now, the other part is now if people have submitted responses. Let me go to the Kectil application. Just ignore if we'll show you your name, but I'll go to, no, it wasn't here. Okay, let me go to forms. It is here. For now. People are going to be sending responses, sending. And now responses are going, if you log into your Google Forms, like where you built the form, you will come here under responses. You'll see how many people have responded. And by summary, you can also see, this is all of the first names that have responded, you know? Yeah, these are all of the surnames that have responded. Now, this is the gender, 54%. Male, 46% female. So this is now the other data analysis bit of it. If you don't want to use a sophisticated application to learn these kind of things, like you've collected information, you've analyzed it, period. Like you don't want to go very specific, unless it's like a scientific research. But to me, I'm a social scientist, like this does for me. So, and then, do you consider yourself a person with disability? Yes. No, maybe. These are the answers that you put in the form, okay? Don't think it is coming from anywhere. Country, we are purely Ugandans. Yeah. And then this is the geographical distribution. 29% came from Central, 32% Northern, 23% Eastern, 6% Western. Now this is, do you use any of the social media? Now you see, let me see the highest here. Instagram, Twitter at 43. Facebook is here, 100%. Is it 100%? No, 88.5%. I didn't see it because I thought it was just, you know, something like a design of this. But Facebook, I think most of you guys use Facebook. So these are based on your responses, you know. Have you participated in a similar course in the past? Yes, only a few people have done so. So you can easily analyze data here. You can see, now these are like the essays. Let's just read one. Why are you interested in the above courses? I'm interested in the above mentioned courses because I believe they will add my life experience, blah, blah, blah. So you can read this and get tired. But this is not giving names because we've only chosen summary. I like this. This is summary. But if you want to go individually, then you go to individual. But I don't want to show someone's name here. Faith Shama. Okay, this is Shama. Shama, Gender, male, So these are the answers from Shama, right? So, but for data analysis, you just want to go by summary. Then now the other last bit of it, you can extract all of this information in Excel. Again, it is called Google Sheets. So you click on this Excel thing, then it will show you like a summary, which you can even print out, which you can, again, you save it, download it. So it shows when the person submitted, their first name, all of this information that I had put in the form, you know. So that is it. And that takes us to the end of Google Forms. And maybe we should have a short break, then we'll come back. Let's have like a 10-minute break, if that's okay. But if there's a question somebody should ask, I'll stop sharing my screen now. If there's a question, please ask. Otherwise, I believe you guys can now do Google Forms, send it out, receive responses, analyze responses, extract sheets, turn it on and off. The other bit, before I go, the other bit I didn't show you was the feedback. After somebody has submitted, like you want to customize some sort of a feedback, maybe thank you for submitting your response, we're going to get back to you within 2 weeks, something like that, you know. So that is going to be under, you go to the settings here, you go to settings, apply to new forms, apply it, wait, presentation, no, responses. Limit responses, defaults. Oh, I tend not to find it. Responses, I think. Okay, I'll go under send and see what is there. We don't have it here. We should have it under settings here. Responses, send a copy of the response, allow editing, limit to one response. No. Presentation, show bar, chat, I think confirmation message is here. So now by default, it will just say your response has been recorded. But I want it to be, I'll say, thank you for giving us your time and feedback to improve the Kectil ICT course. We really appreciate. So like you need to play around with all of these settings, but before you send them out, just try everything, you know, because so where is it? So I just click on save. Now the other thing is also the title of your thing, because this is also going to display. So I will change it to Kectil ICT training feedback form. Then I hit enter on my keyboard and it will save automatically. So I think we are good to go. Let's have a 10-minute break and then we'll be back here with more in store. Just to keep you, we're going to look at Zoom, how you can sign up, set a meeting for people, set a recurring meeting where like you will use the same link every day and forever until you die, and maybe record meetings, give recording rights to people, sharing of screens, and how you can allow people to share screens, how you can make someone a co-host so they can have control of the room. Now you can moderate like the entire Zoom meeting interface. So because we actually chose it because so many people use it today, and we also thought it would be important. But I'm going to only do Zoom, then I show you file conversion, then the rest is going to be on my colleague, I think. All right, any questions? If no questions, then I'll say let's go for a break. We come back at 3:44. Going to write it here on the screen. I'll say back at 3:44. Okay. See you soon. are only going to watch the recording, welcome back from the short break. So we had promised to come back with showing you guys how to convert Word files to PDF, but also how to change PDF documents to Word, how to compress files, and also how to edit PDF. Then I will just show you very quickly how to transfer files on WeTransfer. So, and then I'll invite my colleague to do the rest. But wait, I also have Zoom. I think we'll begin with the file conversion. Yeah, so assuming this is our Word file, which we would like to turn into a PDF, I hope you're seeing my screen. Can you all see my screen? The online guys? Can you?
Yeah, yes, we can.
Okay, nice. So this is Word, and I've saved it. This is the file name. Now I'd like to make it a PDF. So just go to save, then save as. Then I want to take it to documents. Then while you're here, you can now choose the file format. Scroll down to PDF here. And then you say save. And that is it. Let me save and let's see what happens. This is already in PDF format. It's very simple. Sometimes they say do a cover letter, then do a CV as one PDF, you know. So maybe let's say this is your cover letter, then you have a CV somewhere else. Let me put my CV there. I don't know if that's my most current CV. No. Okay. It's not the one. Okay, this is my CV. I'll just copy it because it is in Word. I need to get rid of any space. So I'll highlight everything and I'll copy and I go back to where I want to put it, which is here, because this is my cover letter and I want the CV to be down here. I'll remove that dot and I'll paste it there. So there's the CV on the second page, and on the first page is my cover letter. Now it is one document. I want to save it as a PDF. I'll go there to File, Save As. I choose where I want to save it. Then I'll use this drop down. I'll choose PDF. Then I can even change ICT final day. And I will save. Automatically it's going to convert to PDF. This is now the PDF, and that's my. Even if you want to put your transcripts and other things, you can just copy and paste them in Word, that you just save the whole document as one PDF. I hope that is clear. Otherwise, I am now going to remove my CV because it's not doing anything there, you know. Yeah, and now if you have a PDF and you like to convert it to Word, normally you would be required to have an application to do that, but even the current version of Microsoft Office Word can now convert your PDF into Word. Let's say this is what I want to convert. I click on it, I right click, then I go to open with, then I will scroll, then I come to Word. Okay, there's a question here. Let me close this first.
The current version, which one specifically?
Someone is asking which specific versions. I've tried this with Office 2016, also Office 365, also I think 2010 also does it. Yeah, but I think 2016 and later. Yes. So you just right click. And you go to open with, and you scroll all the way to Word. then you click on what, then it's going to say we will convert your PDF to editable Word document. I'll just say okay, and boom, this is now the PDF converted to Word, and we can still be able to work on it. So I hope this conversion process is clear. Now I'm going to show you how to zip documents. If it's not clear, please let me know. I want to tie these two documents together. They're like two files. I want to tie them together and send it to my boss as a zip. I will show you an example of a zip. This is a zip. They always look like this. It's like a bundle of things, right? A bundle. So I want to put those two as a bundle, you know. Let me open this bundle and see what is inside. Now I will have to extract it first, because this has been zipped. What's up? Okay, open with WinRAR. Let me see. Okay, I think there's a problem with the file. But no worries. Let me just show you how to bundle files or how to zip files. So these are the two I wanted to zip. I'll select both of them by just using a shift. You know, you click on one and then you hold the shift key on your keyboard, then you click on the second one. Okay, let me add a second document. Let me scroll a third one. No, just those two. So you right click. When you have now highlighted the both, then you go to send to, and you go to compress zip folder, you know, and you click there, and then you now type the name of your zip, which is zipped files, and now press enter on my keyboard. Now this is going as one zip. If somebody opens it, which is what we call the unzipping, they're going to see these two, you know, they're together. So sometimes also when you're applying for a job or maybe even at work, your boss can say there are like 10 different files that you have to send to him, but you don't want to even, they're like, let's say it's an image, it's also like a Word doc, it's also a PDF, it's also like a whole bunch of things. You cannot put them in one format. You can just zip them and then you send us one package. So if they unzip it, they're going to see all of them. And for you to unzip, you need to have something for unzipping it. And WinRAR is very important. This application called WinRAR, free. We can also send you and you install it on your computer. Because if you don't have something for unzipping, you're not going to access it. So now I want to unzip this and extract the files which are in the zip. So I'll right click and I'll say extract files. Then I'll go to extract and update files, and I'll choose where I want the files to go. I want them to go to documents, and I'll say, okay. These are the two. I'll say yes, all. So now let's go to our documents and see. Yeah, so these are the two files we've just extracted, as you can see. It still even remains there. So you can keep that one, you extract again another time. You can extract it to different folders. Then you can now read. So that is zipping and unzipping. Oh, sorry, let me share my screen again. Any questions until now? Otherwise, let me take you straight to Zoom, and now you can use Zoom. Zoom is very popular, and since COVID, it has been widely used for e-learning, but also remote working, you know. And I know for some of us, it was like our first experience with Zoom. We had never thought it would be a big thing, you know, but it's now the new normal. Unfortunately, for our training, we are not using Zoom. Actually, when we were sending emails, who are calling you guys somewhere. So can you send us a Zoom link? I said, look, we are not doing it on Zoom because now people are too used to Zoom. So I have Zoom installed here, but I want to uninstall it first. And then, oops. Where is Zoom? If you have any question, please. And we are going to try to go a bit faster because we have to beat the time. Being uninstalled, I think it's now gone. So we need to get Zoom installed. For you to host a meeting or even to join a meeting very peacefully, you need to have Zoom. However, you can also join a meeting even if you don't have Zoom. You can join it on the web. But the best is to have it installed. I'll say download Zoom for Windows and I search. I'll get it from their website. This one, Download Center, Zoom, US. So to ask me to download, this is the right version for me. You need to download the right version. You need to check your PC. Mine is the 64-bit. So this is my version. For 32 people, you'll download this. For Mac, I think for Mac. For Mac users, yeah, I think that's the App Store. So yeah, so I'll go down up here and I'll download this. It's being downloaded, I'll save it. Unfortunately, it will take us a minute to install. But if you also have your computer right there, please have Zoom installed. I can send you this link. Download, then you can download some anytime. So anything in the chat? Okay, it's being downloaded. Unfortunately, we have to wait. I think I have a version already installed, like a setup. Let me see in my downloads. Zoom installer. I don't have it. I don't have Zoom, so. We'll have to wait for it. The internet is a bit sluggish now. But yeah, after Zoom, I'm going to invite my colleague straight away to now come and take you through TeamViewer, which is also another popular application which people use for troubleshooting problems remotely. Well, let me just cross out the things we've learned. I'm not going to show you WeTransfer now because of time. I'm sure you can already use Google Drive to like transfer files in link format and stuff. Yeah. All right. Let's check the progress. It's almost done. It's at 15 MBs out of 19. So that means our internet is actually less than 1 MB per second. Because if it was 1 MB, it would have finished downloading within 19 seconds. This is 2 minutes. No. Yeah, but there's not much to do about it. So it has finally finished downloading. I'll click on it to run the setup on my computer. It's being installed. Let's watch it happen. But if you have a question, please feel free to stop me at any point and ask. I think it is now installed here. So now you need to sign up actually. Let me see, sign in. Okay, sign up is right down here, even on the app. So I'll click on sign up. And then date of birth, we are January 1st, 2000. Oops. Someone's microphone is on. That is Juliet's microphone. Juliet, you might want to, then I will say continue. The email address is kectil.uganda@gmail.com. And I will say sign up. Process is nearly done. So I'll open my email to get the confirmation email sent to verify. This is the email. I'll activate account now and boom, we'll be good to go. It's happening. Give it, first name is Kectil Uganda. I'll put a password. It's very strong. This is the strongest password I ever. Someone can see it if they want, but I'm not going to know it. Wait. So I'll continue. Testing meeting, we don't want to test because we now know how it looks like. I'll skip. Okay, you can even start a meeting now, but what I want to do now is come to the app and sign. Well, you can even set up a meeting from the web, but I really don't recommend that because the app is easier. So kectil.uganda@gmail.com and the password which we put. Sign in. Let's see. Boom, we are signed in. Let's change our profile photo here. First thing, we'll change my picture here. Taking us to the web still, but no worries, we're going to be back to the app. Certain setups have to happen on the web. So I think due to time, my colleague will only show you just the TeamViewer, unless otherwise. There's a question here. Let's hear.
Yeah, you're talking of web and app. Maybe you can explain to some people the difference between web and app.
Okay, I'm going to throw it back to you guys online, and also the ones in the house. What do I mean when I say web? What do I mean when I say app? Can someone tell me? So I want to drag this. So the web is when you go to the www dot, you know? Understand? This is the web, like the website. As I can, like, that's how I can put it now. Let me crop this photo. Be our profile photo. I'm happy with that. I'll save it. So yeah, we are now done. I'm going to go to the app. The photo might change later. Now, if you want to create a meeting, you need to come to schedule. Yes, here. And then you write the name of the meeting. Back to Uganda daily. Okay, I'll say catch up. It starts today at 5. So, but you can even customize it. You can say 4:04 Okay, 4:10 PM. We change it here. And 4 PM, 7 PM, 4. Okay, I'll say 4:15 PM. Duration is going to be 45 minutes. That's like the maximum because this is a free account. But if we had paid for the premium, it would be like forever. Now, I want this to be a meeting where we can use it every day. Like we don't have to create different meetings. And I also want us to join anytime, regardless, you know. This is a recurring meeting. The moment I click on recurring, even the other time now doesn't matter. Because that means even now we can join, anytime we can join, right? So personal ID, I can customize it here by clicking on personal meeting ID, and then I'll change it to Kectil Center 256, something like that. Waiting room is when maybe if you have not yet started the meeting, you as the host, people have to wait in the lobby, like to be admitted. But that's a very annoying process because you have to be clicking admit. So if there are like 100 people, you will click admit 100 times. So for me, I like it that if you have this link, you just go straight to the meeting room. Nobody should direct you. You should just go straight there, you know. So video for the host, you can put it on or even off. I'll put it off, but still when you're in the meeting, you can still play around with all of this, you know. But on start, I want to keep it off. Because on start, sometimes you don't know, you're already starting a meeting, your background is funny, people will see funny things. So I like to keep it off, even for participants off, but they can still turn it on. I'm not sure how to do that. Now, they're asking, okay. You can also put this to your calendar because now this is a Google account that we are using, the Kectil email. So we'll choose Google Calendar so that we can have it. So if you go to your Google Calendar and you've created this meeting, automatically it will be reflected there. There's a question here.
Can you shed more light on a recurring meeting?
Oh, yeah. Recurring meeting means you can have it now, even after again. 10 minutes, even after 5 seconds, it's like anytime you want, every day, recurring. So that means if our 45 minutes is finished, we can still log back again using the same meeting. Anytime, any day, anytime, any day. Yes, but this is a free account. 45 minutes, after 45 minutes, it automatically log out. But if we use the same link again, we'll go back and we'll start counting afresh. You can immediately go back, exactly. So people actually use this method like to save money, just make it a recurring meeting and say, guys, if we are locked out, use the same link to get back to the house. Yes. Then the other option, apart from the recurring, you'll have to choose like the minutes. So it's only for that. So that link only works for that meeting. So once it is finished, or once somebody has handed it, like the host has handed it, you'll need to create another meeting. Yes. So somebody is asking that what's the maximum time allowed? So it depends on your plan. Our plan is the free one. It's actually here. You can read. Your Zoom basic plan has a 40-minute time limit on meetings with three or more participants. Upgrade now to enjoy unlimited group meetings. So we are 40 minutes, so it's 40 minutes. Yes, I'll make it recurring. Yes, so I think we are done, but please don't forget to go to the advanced here. This is very important. Go to advanced and say allow participants to join anytime. Click on that because when you say the meeting starts now, you can be there, but then participants will not be allowed like to get in until it is the meeting time. Or until you are there in the house. Understand? But then here we are saying even a participant can come before you. So I think that is also easier because it will save you. Because now they will try to join and they will not be successful if you don't check that. Then you can also say, I want to mute all participants on entry so that there is no noise. Some people will join like this and their microphone will be on, and it will pick up noise and it will mess up. So you can also mute everyone on entry. So I think that is it. Then I'll just say save. The other options, it's up to you if you want. I will save. There's a hand. I don't know if we can still reverse what we've done, but there was a hand here.
Assuming you've muted the participant, do they have the options of unmuting themselves?
Yes, participants can still mute and unmute when they're already in the house, you know. So the meeting has been created. But now Zoom is asking that which Google account do you want to attach to this? So that the calendar is automatically updated. So I want to attach this account, the Kectil account. And once I choose Kectil and I allow Zoom to access my calendar, they will automatically update. They will know every day from this time to this time, we're going to have this, you know, reminder. So otherwise, even you can ignore the process now. But the meeting has already been set. If you see here, you come to meetings, you'll see Kectil catch up here. So you click on it, and then if you want to start the meeting, you click on start. If you want to copy the invitation, which is very important for people to join, you just click on copy invitation. Now I've copied this invitation. I want to paste it here for you guys to try to join. So it will be something like that, you know. You'll be like, Kectil Uganda is inviting you to a scheduled Zoom meeting. Topic, Kectil Uganda catch up. This is the link, meeting ID, passcode. This is what you share with people, you know. So you've successfully created a meeting, and now you can start your meeting here. Let me start the meeting, but there's going to be a conflict of microphone because I'm using the same device also for big blue button. But if there is echo, I'll say, I'll not take long here, I'll just mute. So now, when you see this screen, you need to click on join with computer audio. I'll mute here. Now I am muted on the Zoom meeting. And this is our photo appearing. Somebody has also joined. So you guys also who are in the online class, I'll put the link, please join. I can see how many people have joined from here. We are now two. I can click there and see who they are. It is me and then ICT. I don't know who ICT is. But also the other thing is you can also change your name once you're in the meeting. You go to more, you just touch on your name and you go to more and you say rename. I'll say robot. And then the name has automatically changed. Thank you, Brian. Thank you, Barbara. I think the house is full. Now all of these guys are muted. That's why you see their microphones and their videos all. So they can unmute from their end and then they can also talk. Now, also the other thing is sometimes you have like a headset or earpieces, but it has not detected automatically here. And you want to set it. So you come to the audio here, and then you see there is a setting thing here. So microphone, right now I'm using, it's using my USB microphone. So it will show all of the microphones that are attached. Thank you, ICT, good to see you, looking great. So you choose the microphone you have. This is a Bluetooth speaker that we have here. This is another microphone that I have connected to this same device. This is also another microphone. And so now, if you don't have a microphone, you need to choose, automatically it's going to choose same as system. That is like your inbuilt microphone for the device, whether it's a phone or it's a computer or a tablet, it's going to be same as system. I don't want to mess up mine. Mine is like that. And for output, this is now the speaker. Do you want to hear through same as system also, like the same computer speaker, or you want to hear somewhere else? So you also choose from here. So that's about microphones. Some people will cry, oh, I'm not hearing you, because they just have to go there and change the right input and sound output devices, and then they are done. So this is for the video. If you click there, people will be able to see you. But even my video, because I have an external camera, that's why it's not connected, I need to change by clicking on that. I need to say integrated camera, and then you will be able to see me just now. This is me. I can turn it off by clicking here. Security, I don't know about that. Someone will tell me. This is the chat where you can type in the group, hey there. Now, very important, when you're chatting, there are two options. You can even chat to a friend who is in the meeting. Like if I want to chat with Godfrey, I just come to click on this little button and I say, I look for Godfrey, this is ICT trainer. Now this message is going directly to the ICT. Hey man, so now I want to say, let us go drinking, you know? I don't want that to go to the group, of course. So that message has gone to Godfrey a lot. But if I sent this message to everyone, you know, let me copy this. If it was everyone, just see, it's going to be embarrassing. Brian is going to see it, I'm going to see it, Godfrey is going to see it, everyone in the house is going to see it. We're like, what's happening? Look, guys, you're going to drink and we are in a serious meeting, you know? You could also get fired. So take note, if you want to send a private message, just use this little button, look for the person who wants to send the message to, and then you write the message and then you send. Even here, it's going to indicate direct message. Then if you want to turn back to everyone, like group, come back here. That's a nice one. And then you say everyone. So now this is going to everyone. Now for raising of the hand, I think you come to reactions, then raise hand. But also you can clap, you can do a thumbs up, you can also laugh, you can cry, you can celebrate. You know, and then if you've raised your hand, it will be like this, yellow. And if you want to lower it down, you'll still go to reactions and lower hand. Now, apps, I don't know about those, and we don't have any apps connected. For recording, because I'm the host, I can also record the meeting. But all of the people are going to get a notification that this meeting is being recorded. Do you want to stay? It's something that Zoom has just updated. It didn't appear like 2 years ago. But again, we are talking about data privacy. That's why even when we were recording our meeting, on the big blue button, we said, guys, if you don't feel you're comfortable, you can leave the house and we can record. So that's the kind of thing. So that message is going to be on your screen and you can just say okay and then you will stay. But if you say cancel, you'll be kicked out immediately. No. So that is Zoom. If you want to leave, you just say end meeting. Now sharing of screen, because right now I'm the only one who can share my screen. I just click on share screen. Then now there are so many windows here open. Which one do I want to share? But very important is you can just share your entire screen. And by default, it is already selected here. So you just come and say share. So this means people are going to see this window. People are going to see anything in the house. People are going to see anything. Even this funny thing, which I wrote, you know, people are going to see, because this is now my entire computer. Again, very important. Only share your entire screen after you've cleaned your desktop, you know, because people will be able to see. Wherever you go, people will see. Wherever you go, people will see, you know. So that is it. Back to Zoom here. To Zoom. I want to stop sharing. Oops, I'm stuck. Someone to help me out. But I know I'll get it. Okay. Sometimes, if you don't know what is open, you just click here on the task view here, and then you see the window you want to go to. I think it is this one, which I want to go to, then I can stop screen sharing first. You can also choose a specific window, like let me go to share. I only want you guys to see this funny note which I made for the office, then I say share. So that means you can only see this window. Even if I change to another window, you're not going to see that. You will only see the toilet. Right now, I'm on another window. I'm seeing Chinese things here, but you guys are still seeing the toilet. You understand? So, still very interesting. So that's just my question. Now, if you're the host and someone who is an attendee would like to share their screen, they are not going to be able to share their screen unless you enable them to share. So you come to the little dot again, and then you say, you just go to advanced sharing options. Then you say all participants. By default, it is only host can share. So you just change to all participants. Who can start sharing when someone else is sharing? Only host. So you need to keep some of the rights just for you, because you're like the moderator. You can't give everyone the same right because you don't know their capabilities in terms of using Zoom. So you keep most of the things, and then only when they request, that's when you can now give them permission. Otherwise, I can also make this guy a co-host. Let me see. Make host. So I can also make Brian the host of the meeting. And then Brian can be able to like moderate the meeting. He can even start screen sharing. He can even record, because only hosts can do certain things. Otherwise, this is Zoom. I'm going to end the meeting for us all. And I hope you guys have picked something. There's a question here before we close.
What are those features that only the host can access and the rest cannot access?
So, like sharing of the screen is one. And ending the meeting for everyone is also the host. For you, you can only have this thing of leave. I think Godfrey right now, you can only see leave, and Brian can also see leave. But for me, I can end for everyone. And then we say, let's go home. But for you, you can only leave. And that's also the same with the big blue button. If I can show you my screen, if I come here, you see there is end meeting, there's leave meeting, you know. So I have the privilege, you know. So, yeah. So, and then sharing the screen, it's only you who can control. You need to control who can share the screen. You need to turn it on. Then you can also make another person co-host. Then also the other right is recording. Participants cannot record, but only you can start a recording. Like this, I've now started a recording, you know. And I will stop recording. So that is Zoom, guys. I hope you will not mess up. I hope if your boss requests you to set up a meeting, it's not going to be a problem. I advise that you set like a recurring meeting. After all, it's just a meeting. You can also delete it. Also, to go back to delete it, let me first end this. You see, end for all. I'm going to end for everyone. But before I end, there's also another question here. The guy is attending online. You seem to be very silent. The people here are asking.
Assuming you choose leave meeting, who becomes the host?
What?
You click on leave meeting as the host.
So if I leave the meeting, okay, someone is going to respond.
There's a question.
Okay, there's a question. Guys, unfortunately, I have not tried this, but it's also something we could try. I don't want to lie, but looks like if I leave the meeting, because now I'm the boss, maybe the first attendee is going to, no, I don't think, because there's also data privacy. Maybe the meeting is going to end. Maybe, let me try while Brian is still there. And Brian, you can tell us on the big blue button what your experience is. I'm going to leave the meeting now. You need to assign someone first, you see. You cannot leave the meeting unless you give someone the right, like someone to step in your shoes. But I don't trust this guy, so I'll just end the meeting. Okay, let me give Brian a sign and leave. So Brian is automatically now the host. But if I go back to the meeting, wait. Okay, this is the other recording that was being done. But now I'm going back to Zoom, to the app. I like to use the app. And I want to go back there and see if, so there is this meeting, I go to start. Okay, if you don't want to see this message and you know you are using the same device, like the same headset, the same earphone, you can just tick this. Then you will not see it again. But that only do that if you're sure. But for me, I'm always, sometimes I remove my headset, sometimes I have it on. So just to be on a safer side, I only do this option when. So you see, right now my audio is not yet connected. It's still saying connecting audio. Until I click here, then it will be okay. Okay, Brian, I will now reclaim my host. There are now two options. I can get back my rights, or I can now stay as an ordinary person. So I want to get it back. I'm now the host. So this was really good. And thanks for asking, man. Like, this is awesome, you know. So I'm going to end the meeting for everyone. That was for demonstration. Now back to you guys for questions. Yes, a question? Okay, there's a question here.
We have Zoom, big blue button, and then Microsoft Teams, then there's Google Meet. Can you compare for us all of them? And why is Zoom very popular?
Okay, if you ask me which one I prefer, I would say I prefer the big blue button. It is not something that is common in Uganda, I can tell you for sure. It's German. But Zoom is, I think, Chinese. And there are like a whole bunch. Let me just get for you video conferencing applications. Okay, let me say top 10, and then you'll see the list. There is Microsoft Teams. There is Google Hangout. There is also Duo. There is Google Meet. Everyone is now Zoom is number one. Microsoft Teams, Skype, WebEx, BlueJeans Meeting, GoToMeeting. I remember using GoToMeeting in 2015. It was GoToMeeting. There was no Zoom. There was, maybe Zoom was there, but it was still sidelined, you know. So the list is endless. Even Big Blue Button is not anywhere close to. I don't know whose analysis this is, and I don't want to say like I trust it 100%, but for me, I'm very happy with the Big Blue Button, because you don't have to install an application. Then you can record the meeting, and then you can also have breakout sessions. You can also have these other things where you can, you know, you can write on the screen and someone can see, can also upload a presentation, and you don't just have to share, you can upload it. It will be very, very neat, you know. But you guys will only have 1 hour of Big Blue Button, because you're on basic plans. For us, we are on a premium plan. We can even have a meeting the whole day. That's why we never change this link. And yeah, that's Big Blue Button if you ask me. I would say Zoom is also good. So you need to do your homework and you see how long is your meeting going to be? How many people are you planning on bringing on board? And are they capable? Like, which one are they more familiar with? Because you don't want to train people again. Like for Big Blue Button, because we knew it was totally new, so we had to do a video showing you guys how to use the Big Blue Button. Someone was still asking, I've installed Big Blue Button, but I cannot access the meeting. I said, go and watch the video, because we are not asking you to install anything. You know? Yes. So that is it, guys. If there is any question, please ask. What's the difference between Big Blue Button and Zoom? I would say they are very similar, because one, they can let you admit people. Two, you can also record. Three, you can also raise your hand. You can have all of the emojis. You can have a chat, you know. Like the difference is Zoom, you can also attend Zoom just on the web, like we are attending Big Blue Button just on the web. But Big Blue Button also has an app, you know. They are like more or less the same, like I can tell you. So if you ask me, because I'm more familiar with the Big Blue Button, I've used it for 1 year consecutively. So that's why I say I like. Someone is saying, kindly take us through how to make breakout rooms. Brian, breakout rooms are only for premium users on Zoom. You know, we cannot have breakout rooms in the free version. But in our Big Blue Button, for sure, there is what we call breakout rooms. I think we tried this on Friday when we were just starting, and it worked out very well. So it's still the same way you do it, you know. So there's a private message from a team. I don't want to open it when you guys are Okay, you can ask me privately. I'm not sharing my screen now. You can ask me or team, and then I'll respond. But if you think it can also benefit people, please just ask in the. You can just ask in the forum. Barbara is saying I'm low, but I think my volume is really up. Like, I don't know. Look. No, I think I'm good. So guys, I'm going to hand you over to Godfrey, who is going to take you through TeamViewer. But from me, I would say very big thank you and congratulations, because you can now do all of this, maybe things you didn't do before, and things that you can now start doing tomorrow, you know, and your boss will be blown away. So yeah, I'm going to give us 1 second. We are changing the computer, and we are shifting to a second computer because
we have a new trainer
now in the house. But before I do that,
hello.
I can hear you good.
Wow, it has been a long time, a long day. I hope everyone is fine. And welcome back to my side.
So we're just reconnecting, so 10 seconds, we'll be back. But let me see if there's a question in the chat. Thanks, Master.
There's a question in the chat.
Yes, hello, guys. Are you able to get me? Okay, that is wonderful. That is great. Back to Windows 11. Guys, I have something amazing that I got today from Microsoft. They're releasing Windows 12, which is yet to come up, I think it will be next year. So we are the guys who have been subjected to take a review and verify some errors which need to be corrected. So feel happy. And first testing Windows 11, which is this one. On top of that, I'm not going to take much time. I just want to show you something very small, and this one is only applicable to those who are taking ICT to another level, more especially someone who wants to be a system administrator, you want to be a hacker, you want to do a lot remotely, actually. So let me go straight to open TeamViewer. If you have it on your computer, you are able to open and also try the following that you are going to try. TeamViewer is an application which is open source, and it can be used on any platform. I use it a lot on my Linux system. I use it a lot on my Mac system. I use it a lot on my Microsoft system. So if you have it, go to the browser, click there, download. It is a very small file. You'll have it in your system ready. So let us open our TeamViewer and we see how we set it up. There are two things here we need to understand with TeamViewer. One, we can use it on a LAN. What do we mean by LAN? Those who are doing network engineering, you understand by the word LAN. That is local area network. You can use it within your local area network. That is within your organization, or within your office, or within the machines that are connected within your home. So that one, it means by local area network. Then wide area network, that simply means it can go beyond. If I'm in Kampala and you are the other side of the country, or you're in another country, or you're in another continent, that one is wide area network. So I can have access on your computer that is in US, that is in UK, that is in Canada, anywhere, using only this application. So how do we do it? Oh, I can still also have access within the computer, which we have within this room here, without moving from. For example, you want a file from your HR's computer, you are in the Department of Management, or you're in the Department of ICT, You don't need to move from here to there. Or your accountant asking for you to install for him or for her a certain software, for example, QuickBooks, Tally, and so on. You don't need to move from one room to another room. Or you have a client is calling you in Makerere, and for you are in the city center, or you are in Gaba, you are in Munyonyo. You don't need to move from there to go and install for them the software that they need on their computer. You can do everything within your computer where you are seated. So from today onwards, we're also going to be using the same thing. You may have a problem back at your place there, problem in your computer, so you can get in touch with us. We shall help you to troubleshoot it using this software. So for those who are becoming system administrator, network engineer, and so on and so on, this is a very powerful tool. It has launched. We have so many that we can set up. We can set up security on it, but this one is going to be another level of our training, which I'm not going to show everything about TeamViewer, but I'm going to show you the basic. Come here, different versions can show you in different way. I can come with the settings, just a small setting a bit that we need to do. To differentiate between what we mean by local area network and wide area network. So under security, I can configure this system in such a way that I can enter there without you knowing that I'm already in your computer, but I can do whatever thing I want on your computer without you knowing. So isn't that one beautiful? It is. But yeah, so I'm still just explaining a little bit of the future on it. So here, you can select it, allow either for administrator only or for all users. That means when you switch on your computer, this application will run on the background automatically without you seeing that the application has opened. So that is how hackers sometimes they used to penetrate into your computer and they be able to get any information they want. We also have video conferencing here. You can use it for communication, for texting, for meeting, and so on. All of them they are there. We have already covered in the other previous version. So from here, this one, it is showing that we can connect it remotely. What does it mean here? Here, I can punch in some other computer's ID. This is my ID. When I give you this ID into your computer and plus this password, you punch it there, you're on a wide area network from wherever you are, you'll be able to log in into this system and you do whatever thing you can do. So I'll ask someone who is online there, if you have TV already, just put in this ID and put in this password. I will see from here that there's an incoming connection from wherever I don't know. So if you have it, try. Okay, I hear Ronald, you want to try with me? Just here, simply punch in this number. Then when a dialogue opens, punch in this password and you'll be able to access my computer from wherever you are. Are they seeing the screen? Yes, the number is there on the screen for you and the password is there. Punch in and you let us see from this side. We shall also verify with you that you already logged into my computer.
Yes, I'm seeing Joel on a bigger screen and the shared screen is small.
Oh, sorry, but you can always zoom whatever is on the screen. There are those four arrows in the top right. You could have just click on those and then we'll have like a full view of everything. Sorry, I'll just turn off my video.
Okay, thank you.
So there's some information. Yes, so someone has taken control over my computer. So there, you move and do anything. You can click on the start, you can click on the recycle bin, you can do anything. So from there, you can help me and solve for me problem on my computer when for me I'm seated seeing what it's doing. Or I can also do whatever thing I'm doing here when it's seen from the other side. So you may find that you have your manager or your bosses within your company and you are using the organization computer. So they may call a technician who will come and install this one on the background. Or you can be here doing your things on the computer, trying to download, yet your boss said, please, let us use internet for only office work, not downloading personal files. So for you can be there downloading, you open your browser, maybe you open Google Chrome, you are there downloading files. When you see the boss physically, you minimize and you open Opera, your email is open, but the boss will be back in his office there and is monitoring using this tool and see whatever thing you are doing. Please just get back to the other side desktop one. Yes, so from there, sorry that this window is quite new to you, but the principle is all the same. You can click on the window button so that people can see.
One near search.
Click on that window button, four small blue square, yes. So you can open Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and so on. So it's doing it from where?
Ronald is doing it from, I think, Gulu.
I don't know.
Kampala, we don't know.
Or even beyond Uganda. Yeah, a question will come. Just hold on a moment. But don't lose your question. Ronald, from there, when you look at the bottom side where there's the white team viewer, there is where you are seeing a video. When you click on video, we can video conference. When you click on it, don't click anything. Don't click. When you click on the headset, that means we can communicate on audio. We can even use text. So therefore, you are in US, I'm in Uganda. We can communicate without buying airtime. We don't have airtime, but we can talk the whole day, the whole night, and so on. So that is the beauty of TeamViewer besides doing this other administrative work. Yes, someone has a question. You can ask the question before we proceed. You can close. Ronald, you can close my... Okay, just leave there. Let me close for myself. Okay, you can click on don't save. So I may be having a problem with doing a certain piece of work. I'm stuck with the software. I don't know how to use it. Then I get the right to an expert somewhere there. He will do for me the whole work, even save it for me. Even he can copy from my computer, for example. Click on the window button again. Are you there, Ronald? Oh, we have a network problem. So he can take, he's having the whole control over my computer. He can change even the password of my computer. He can even block me from using my own computer, whereby I cannot use it again. Let us stop there. We shall meet for those who want more in terms of security, hacking, system administration, and all that. We can make different arrangements, and then we shall have it in future to come. If there's no question, I can...
Yeah, some questions, chat.
Okay.
Someone is saying how many people can take control.
Okay, how many people can take control over? They can be as many people as they want. But the one who is moving the mouse is not having that control to click at that point. But there are very many people who can join within your computer. Or you can also join very many computers at the same time. You keep on switching. For those who have gone far with ICT, you can take a look at an application called the VMware. In VMware, you can have multiple computers within that application, maybe 5, 10 and above, and so on. So that is the same thing that is in the virtual, then TeamViewer is the physical world. You can control a computer in Kampala, you control a computer in Masaka, you control a computer in Gulu using only one computer that you are seated on.
Then someone is saying, pardon on the process, please.
Okay,
can
pardon. Okay, I'm going to close. I'm going to close then, Ronald. Let me close. I can also close him from here. He can also close me from there. So either way, when I close, we go back to mine. And then, Ronald, please explain to people. I hope you are seeing my screen. Explain me, I demonstrate. Then you will read for me your team viewer's number and the password, and I connect you there. But it is not that you should always be reading a password. And the ID, there's a way you can configure it in such a way that anytime I click there, I don't need your password, I don't need your ID. I know what I can configure there. Then anytime I want, I can enter in your computer without you knowing. That one will be for another level. Yes, Ronald, go on. Please confirm if is he having any issue or we have lost him. What do we do on it? Okay, if not,
raising hand, please.
Yes.
Ronald, you can talk. He said he got issues with audio.
Oh, you're having issues with your audio. Okay, let him type there, then you will read for us. Otherwise, I can still repeat for someone who... I can still repeat. Okay. Okay, with anyone else, what you do, open your TeamViewer application if you have it installed in your computer, or you can also use the web version. The difference between the app and the web is that the app, you download it and install it in your computer or on your phone. Then the web is it, you have to use a certain search engine, a browser, for example, Google Chrome, Opera, Firefox, Safari, Mozilla, and so on. So that is the difference between the two. So once you have the application installed in your computer, you just simply launch it by opening. Full stop. Once you open and you have internet connection, here it will show you green. That one, if you are from one network to another, that is on a wide area network. But if you are in a local area network still, the setting, it changes a bit, okay? So between the two, you have to see how you can differentiate that I'm on a local area network or I'm on a wide area network. Now, if you are using the computers that are connected within your organization, within your workplace, for example, from the security, from the drivers department, from account department, from the something like that. So you have to click this one and you accept it. Local area network. Then you click OK. So here it will be green if I'm using only local area network. But the reason why it has gone red, because I'm using wide area network. It is now back. It has detected that, okay, you can use both on local area network and wide area network. But if you are working to someone who is not within your organization, not next to, who is not on the same network, then you have to take the option for wide area network. That is the only difference between the two. So let us change from here. Where did we check? Where don't have forgotten. Who is taking us there? Then you deactivate this. And then from here, it will change a bit. After it will be ready, once you have network, and you'll be able to connect it. I'm going to request someone there who is, if you don't mind, to share your screen with the rest of the team for demonstration purpose. You can read for me your TeamViewer's number. You read for me the password. Then we see if we can log into another computer. Do you have any volunteer who is having TeamViewer installed on your computer? Yes. If you don't mind, you can read the number. We shall just see, show how we can enter there, and then we shall close. We shall close so that we don't expose your information to the entire world. Yes, or Tim? You see for me if he's speaking, because so that you can hear who he's typing. Oh, guys, no one is having TeamViewer, those who are online. If someone in the house here, you have TeamViewer there, you can also read for us the number. I'm not seeing the chat. I don't want to go back the other side. Just read for me the ID number. 572-955-574. Yeah, just a moment. Let me click so that people can see what happened. If you are connecting to another computer, this ID here is this one here. For the other person, then you click on connect. So from here, it will show you connected to partner. It will take time depending on the speed of the network or depending on how many servers it has to go through or how many networking devices it has to go through in order to reach that very computer. So from here, it is authenticating. Once it is done, it will give me certain information. Let me repeat again. Sometimes the reason why it may accept or it may refuse, you may find that on the other end, they have configured sub-security parameters. Someone may can block incoming unauthorized authentication or connectivity depending on the firewall that they have before their network. So I have someone I can charge of my computer. Okay, fine. From there, so you can do something. By the way, from there we can also transfer files. Just leave there and connect it to whose viewers. First, read the password. No, people are connecting. We We don't need to connect in multiple connections. Yes? G? GW? G? Yes? Double H? U. Okay, let's see if we connected to his machine. Let me first say, okay. So yes, this is what it shows if you are connecting. It is crossing Africa, going to US, going wherever, searching that computer. So this is what this person is seeing. Now, let me show you that I can take charge of his computer. I can come here. I minimize, I can do anything. So I see this is a different computer, but someone had connected through me. So please, that person, let me end you. So that I see how I connect it to we remain with the only one person there, one computer there, which is this one. So here I can even create folder, I can do anything. I can come to my computer, I check the property of this computer from here. Everything about this computer I have control. At the same time, he's also seeing what I'm doing. But there's a way we can do, and he doesn't see what I'm doing. I can take any information without him knowing. So here I can even come and I see the capacity of his computer, everything. So I'll take and charge of his computer, right? I'm going to end that so that we don't see your screen, people, for security reasons. So let me end. So we have ended. We are back here. That is enough for TeamViewer. If you need more on that, system administration, network engineer, and so on, hacking, programming, and so on. You know what you want. We are here to support you. Yes, we have a question on the ground.
Someone has taken control of my computer. Can I also do anything instead?
Yes. If someone has taken control of your computer, there are two ways. He can give you permission to do something, or he can deny you permission to do anything. I hope I've answered. So depending on who has taken control over your machine. So I believe we all know how to check when we are going to purchase a new computer. What are the features that you need to look for when you are going to purchase a new computer? More especially those who get you are in charge of purchasing for company computers. So what are the specifications do you look for when you are purchasing a new computer? If you all know, I wish you all the best. Let us meet. I don't know when, but we are here any day, any time. See you. Bye-bye, everyone.
Okay.
Okay, guys, I think we have come to the end of this training. Sir?
Okay. No, it's fine. Is it this one? The first one? Okay, I think I'll stop sharing the screen now. I just wanted to like give some brief information now going forward. We've successfully done this and I'm very proud of all of you. You know, initially we were worried that maybe you guys will not manage this kind of pace, but also this kind of technology that we have introduced, you know, like I don't know how many trainings you guys have attended that is like a blend of online and literally we had two classes attending one training, and that has been very, very successful because you guys were willing to learn. And now you can take this kind of knowledge elsewhere, and you can also show people that, you know, you attended the training. So now what I ask of you is that we have not covered everything. We've only shown you how to do a few things. Now it's over to you to actually take it further to the level you'd like to take it, you know. So do as much practice as you can.
And we are still going to be here to support you anytime you would need any kind of support. Also, we still have more trainings in the pipeline. Next weekend, we are going to start business skills training. So if you've also indicated your interest in this, take note, we are still going to send you emails. But for those that have taken ICT training, please make sure to submit all of our assignments. For today, I would like to give you an assignment of doing a Google form and be like an event. Maybe you're inviting people to your birthday or something. Have some photo or graphic or photo of yourself at the top of the form. Maybe one or two or three or five questions, which maybe a few should be mandatory and others are optional, and also a mix of question types like multiple choice, short answers, date, stuff like that. And then kindly invite us, send us the link, and we'll have a look at that and we'll fill it out and we'll tell you what we feel about it and also advise you on how you can make it better. So because the whole idea is we'd like to see if you can really apply the knowledge you've learned in the real world, like in the industry or even at school, you know. So that is it from today. I don't know if my colleague has any assignment on TeamViewer, but that's what I have for you today. So now you can see that we have given you an assignment on PowerPoint, on doing a logo, and on doing an Excel sheet, which you haven't sent back. And when you're sending back the Excel, we want you to have your signature in your email. Don't forget that. We are still going to send an email, just a follow-up email, and we will highlight all of this in case you forgot. Yes, that is for everyone, whether you attended physically or you attended online. So I would like to get some feedback from you guys, whether you're here in the house or you're like attending online. Like, feel free to just speak up, but I'm going to put some questions I am going to put some poll questions in the for the online guys. So the question is, what are the three things you've learned? What are the three things you have learned until now? Okay, I mean from the time you started this to now, you know. So I want you to write some, wait, hang on for a second. I'm still doing something here. It will come over to your screen. Oh, user response. Okay. So just type in the chat like one line, you know. Sorry, I'll send you a question in the poll. You know, I think you have it. Kindly type those three things and send it to us. Also, for the people in the house, I'm asking the same question. What are the three things that you have learned through the 4 days of tents, but we think also rewarding training, you know? And after this, I'm going to send just the last question. I hope we'll end at exactly 5. Is it 4:56 now? So let's finish this activity in 4 minutes. The next question is going to be, what are the three things we should have done to make this training like meet your expectations? You know, because we want to improve this, and for the people who are going to come back. Guys who are typing in the chat, no, you have a button, we've sent it to you. Please just use the buttons to submit your responses. And you can only get certificates after you've submitted all the assignments. We've seen people ask if it's attendance, if you know you have not attended fully, like we have attendance forms here, we note who has attended. But the whole idea is not for the certificate. I mean, anyone can get a certificate anytime, but we are more interested in like the skills you get and how you'd use the skills to take your career or your
education even further, you know. So everyone is going to get a certificate for as long as you attend it, but first get the assignments over to us and then we can talk about the other things. Also yesterday people were asking about t-shirts and stuff, so we responded in the WhatsApp group. We said we are looking into the t-shirt issue, but my bottom line here is that it's never about a t-shirt, it's never about the food, it's never about the certificate, but it's about the skill, you know, like the skill sets that you're going to walk back home with and apply in your various fields, you know. So those we can do, even we can do them now, even we can do them tomorrow, but first get the deliverables done and then the rest will just come automatically. Someone is saying I missed yesterday's lessons. Guys, also very important is that we send you emails and the emails are very detailed. Please read, because if you saw the email from us this afternoon, Walter, we attached a link to yesterday's recording, like something like 5 hours, you know. So that means you did not read today's email. So very important, because that's the only way we communicate, you know. Like you can only ask if you've not received a particular information. Right, so we'll still send those to you. Actually, what we're going to do is we'll send you PowerPoints for the 4 days, and we'll put video links for the 4 days, and then we are going to ask you to get our assignments to us. Then we'll give back the certificates to you. And also about the certificates, we are going to do a Google form that you will fill out with the names that you want to be on the certificate. I've already shown you a sample of the certificate. And sorry, Walter, your Windows crashed. So you need to install TeamViewer and then we can fix your Windows for you. Yeah, so you know the easier way of doing it now. Any questions? Let me see how many people have responded to the poll. Look, people are typing. But Walter, we have sent you something, and Sempija, please, and Julio and Davis, we've sent you some links on your screens. Please type your responses. I don't see you guys typing anything. We've sent you links, you know. Check on your screen. That's also what sets us apart. We are unique, like we want to do things electronically. Okay. Some people say they don't see. Okay, no worries now. Type in the chat, what are the 3 things that you've learned since we started? Just type 3 things, and then the next question is going to follow. What are the 3 things we should have done that we didn't do that would have made like a whole new world for you? Yeah. Just be as honest as possible, because, you know, like we want to improve. And people on the ground, if somebody has, like, you can comment. Or if you have only 1 or 2, also you can tell us. Yeah, it is not mandatory. Like, we care about your, some people are not comfortable writing, some people are not comfortable talking, that's absolutely fine. But it's our hope that you've learned something, and that all of these fears and all of this kind of shyness is going to go away. Because also that's like the one thing we stand for. The other trainings are going to be on leadership, on communication, on business development. So you can't really succeed if you're not bold enough, no. So Barbara, anyways, the guys who are typing, okay, I'm going to publish now. The people are saying TeamViewer, people are saying, okay, let me see. TeamViewer, communication, PowerPoint, TeamViewer, Excel, for analysis, Zoom, hyperlinks, making. Oh my, it's like a whole bunch of things. You can see it for yourself there on the screen. So we are really blown away by this, and we hope that you learn even, like we've not shown you everything, to be honest. We've been working under a very strict timeline. Let me see, my writing skills on sending emails have improved. Great. Because it would upgrade my skills that I've gained now in the short while. Yeah, so this is all the beginning of learning. I can assure you, Jackson, you know, this is on the beginning. However, the one thing I want to tell you is that it also depends on you. You know, some people after here now, they will not take any initiative like to learn anything on their own. So you need to challenge yourself and you need to ask and ask and ask. Designing items using Canva, now Google Forms, TeamViewer, those are my submissions. Thank you so much, Julio, and we hope that you learn even more. Okay. I think these are really interesting. So now let's go to the very last one and then we'll call it a day. Please, if you don't mind, just tell us the three things that we should have done that we didn't do or that we could do in the future that could make this, you know, like a whole new world for you. Sending another poll, just 1 second. Somebody says their perspective on ICT has changed. To be honest, I can tell you everything around the world now rotates around ICT. Tell me anything that doesn't need ICT, you know, like you still need to. Walter, your microphone popped up and we had to mute you. So I'm posting another poll question and please answer just quick. What are the three things we should have done or can do to make your learning even more fun? So you can just list those things. Or if you really think you cannot do it using the links, you can also just post it on the group chat. Yeah, so we are doing what we call feedback evaluation. We are doing evaluation because we want to like be perfect next time. Is this mine? Guys who are online, sorry. Here we are drinking something and we're also biting something. So the next time you come, you will get something. If you haven't liked our Facebook page or our Instagram or our LinkedIn, please do so. And if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, also please do so, because those are very important to us. And we are going to pass very important communication also through those channels. And let's keep this rolling. I hope to see most of you again in the next training. But first, let me see the responses on our last question. Okay. Only two people are responding. Come on, guys. Vivian, please respond. Nelson, please respond. Paul, respond. Fred and Julio. Can we respond quickly? Somebody is interested in web design. If we had introduced it. Web design. Someone is saying extend learning to gain more. Have a wider session on IT. Just love it. Wow. Keep up the good work. Someone is saying obtain professionalism and teach accordingly. Okay, improve. Yeah. Someone is saying Microsoft e-business. I think you're talking about e-marketing and stuff. Okay. Those are coming. Actually, our business skills training is coming next weekend. So you guys can still come, you know. And by the way, guys, like we have started really small and we hope you appreciate. We are only a CBO and we are not being funded by any government or anything. We're just doing this And I'm really happy that you guys loved it. We are going to improve, I promise. Because we have the skills here, we have the training team who are even volunteering their time and their skills to enrich people. Now we only have Vivian who has not responded. Vivian and Julio, you have links there. Okay, I'll address a few of these things that you guys have pointed out. Kindly, I need more training on ICT, otherwise I have learned a lot. I think a bit of improvement on publicity and maybe outing with the whole team just for fun. That's awesome. So I'll respond to a few of those. I need more training on ICT. Yes, there is another session coming up in December. So be sure to join. And those that have requests for special packages like web design, hacking and stuff, please email us with your special request. And also, don't forget to join our WhatsApp group. It's called Tech Wins. If you know a friend who is part of this team, kindly invite them. For the guys who are coming here physically, like, we are sorry, like, we couldn't do much for you because you have to use your own transport, you have to take care of your own needs, except just for the little refreshment that we provide and the water and stuff. So, but also we think this is an investment that is a worthwhile investment. Like, you have, otherwise you would pay like to learn this at school, pay a fee, then buy food for yourself, get transport for yourself, get accommodation by yourself. So we hope what we've done, like the little we've done, was helpful. The online guys, we didn't give you anything, but you sacrificed. Actually, what we'd like to do, if possible, next time, if we have a serious group of people, but they are limited by data and stuff, we will see how to work around that. That is also what we have. That is, if we get the opportunity to like help a few of you. But unfortunately, we can't really do support for 50 people, you know, stuff like that. So let's keep in touch and receive emails from us. Don't sign out of our mailing list. Learning programming languages, coding and stuff, yes. Why not? Like, we are a fully fledged ICT institution. This is like an academy, but we don't only offer ICT courses. There is business, there is nature conservation, there is women empowerment and advocacy, there is community health, there is leadership, you know. But we have specialists in all of these fields. Let me just publish the results from what people have said. And you guys can see it there on your screen. So people are saying web design, you know. For me, I can tell you that you've learned a lot of skills. First of all, how to use the big blue button. There are already a few universities in Uganda that are using big blue button, like UCU for their e-learning, and most of them are actually coming to that. So if you're one of the people from such kind of institutions, then you're better off. They could even hire you as a big blue button expert, you know, just to advise your colleagues. Yeah. So guys, we can officially close now unless somebody has a hand. There were some hands up. So if you have to say something, just unmute and talk. Otherwise, it was truly, 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 truly amazing to... Okay, please unmute. Somebody is raising a hand. Let's just hear from this person. Let's hear from this person, please, please, please. Instead of just keeping the hand up. 1 minute, I want to show you something. 1 minute. A question. If I turn off the computer connected to a TeamViewer and it's powered off, do I still have to access to it and its files? No. If you have closed your computer, you've lost the connection, you need to connect again. That's what I can say, even without inviting my colleague to clarify, you know. So any other questions? So Wait, there is something you're going to hear. Sorry, guys. So the online guys, there is a music coming your way, and we are saying congratulations.
Celebration. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be.